Ma'am, you have the floor.
Salamat po, Mr. Chair. Tanungin ko po muna, please, si Dr. Sebastian, dating USEC Sebastian. Magandang umaga po sa inyo.
Good morning, ma'am.
Dating USEC. Yes, sir. Sir, news reports say that certain quarters are mulling criminal and or administrative cases against you. However, you told this Blue Ribbon Committee na you proceeded in good faith. Ano po ang nagpapaniwala sa inyo na si Presidente at si ES na inaasahan ko talagang makarating sa hearing natin ngayong umaga, what made you believe that they, the President and the ES, were supportive of the information? Of the importation? Sorry.
Good morning, Mr. Chair. Good, Madam Senator, good morning. Good morning to the members of the committee. There were the sugar shortage, supply shortage, is greatly manifested by the rising price of sugar in the market, Your Honor. And this was already giving a lot of concern from different sectors, from the private sector, from the industry, and even from the other departments of government. They were already expressing their concern. And this was tackled during our meeting in Malacañang on August 1, 2022.
So yun po yung binanggit ni Chair sa established facts.
Yes,
yung pulong nung August 1, nung binrief ninyo, mga dating liderato ng SRA, si Presidente tungkol sa sugar situation.
Not just SRA officials, Your Honor, because this was a DA meeting with the President. So there were other people present, like other officials of the Department of Agriculture. You know.
Who other officials were there, Doctor?
The Undersecretary for Policy and Planning was there, Undersecretary Mercy Sumbilia. The SRA Administrator was there. The PCA Administrator was also there, Administrator Benji Madrigal. The President of Land Bank was also there, Your Honor.
Salamat, sir. So at the end of that meeting, with all of those agriculture officials present, kasama na po kayong mga dating liderato ng SRA, nakausap nyo si Presidente. ES was there, of course, no?
Yes, Your Honor. Only Administrator Sarapica was there, Your Honor. The other members of the board were not there.
So at the end po of that meeting, ano po yung nagbuo ng conviction ninyo na both the President and the ES supported importation of sugar?
There were two things that the President wanted us to act fast, Your Honor, and which he expressed during that meeting. That is one, the reclassification. We have to do it as soon as possible. Reclassification from reserve to domestic use of sugar. Then second is the need to augment our local supplies through importation.
And was that explicitly said by the President?
Yes, Your Honor. That was one of the part of the briefing that the SRA Administrator gave, and also the President agreed that there's a need to consider that. In fact, Administrator Sarapica was given instruction to start preparing a sugar importation program, Your Honor.
And the ES was at that meeting kung saan sinabi ni Presidente, pangalawa sa gusto niyang gawin ninyo kaagad sa SRA ay i-supplement yung supply through importation.
Yes, Your
Honor. Sumuporta ba si ES sa ganong sinabi ni Presidente or may binigay silang ibang opinion?
There were no objection to the importation program, Your Honor. I did not hear any objection or any
with the permission reservation. Of Senator
Taveros, yes, Mr. Chair.
We recognize the arrival of Senator De La Rosa as well as the virtual presence of Senator Pimentel. I saw his face a while ago. But before you proceed, liwanagin ko lang ito, ha. Doon sa with the indulgence of Senator Ontiveros.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Doon po sa testimony ni yung statement ni Executive Secretary, and I'm referring to his previous appearance here, ang sinabi niya, ang binigay, ang gusto raw po ay 62,000 60,000 kilos. Kayo naman, ang sinasabi nyo dun sa affidavit nyo, 62,826.6 metric tons. Para magkaiba po yung 62,000 kilos at 62,826 metric tons. So, alin po yung tama dito?
That is the reclassification, Your Honor. So, I think in my affidavit, we also attach the document that supports it. So, it's just the exact figure.
Pareho ba yung 62,000 kilos sa metric tons?
Based on document, I quoted the exact number, Your Honor. That's why it's 62,800 something.
So, mali si EES, sabi mo, sinasabi mo ngayon. Si CES, 62,000 kilos. Ikaw, 62,826 metric tons. Alin na mas marami doon?
The one that I quoted is based on the document itself, Your Honor. So, that's
exactly... So, sinasabi mo ngayon, mali si Executive Secretary.
I don't know, Your Honor, where...
You were here when he testified. And I'm referring, Senator Ontiveros, to the statement of the good Executive Secretary that it was 62,000 kilos. The transcript will bear me out. So
yes, Mr. Chair.
Can the transcript be given to Senator Ontiveros? So, sinasabi mo na ngayon, Yusek Sebastian, mali si ES?
I'm not saying that you're wrong, but what I'm saying
pareho
is that...
Pareho ba yung 62,000 kilos sa 62,000 metric tons?
No, Your Honor. But what I'm saying in my affidavit is that I'm citing the exact figure based on the document that was
so
provided.
May nagkamali dito, isa lang dito ang tatama, di ba?
Maybe the ES
typographical
was just giving a rough estimate, Your Honor, not exactly the number.
So ikaw yung correct.
Based on document, Your Honor, that is what
thank you, Senator Ontiveros.
Salamat, Mr. Chair. To continue, former Yusek Sebastian. So tama po ba yung conclusion ko sa mga sinabi nyo so far na naniwala kayo, inakala ninyo na supportive si Presidente sa importation dahil sinabi nila na one of the two things he wants the SRA to do ay i-supplement yung current supply through importation. At naniwala kayo, inakala ninyo na supportive si ES sa importation dahil hindi sila nag-object sa ganong sinabi ni Presidente. Tama po ba?
Yes, Your Honor. And in addition to that, there was also the August 4 meeting where I got the feedback. Although I was not in that meeting, I got the feedback from Administrator Serapica when he emailed me that he was instructed to actually draft the sugar importation program.
Okay, so
by the President, Your Honor. And if you are instructed to draft the sugar importation program, Your Honor, that means you are already aware that there's an importation that has been planned, or even the number that is supposed to be imported is already, they've already been informed about it, Your Honor.
Okay, we'll get to the numbers a little later po. Pero obviously, no, kung pinadadraft si Mr. Serafica ng plano or programa para sa sugar importation, pabor ang pagtingin sa importation, hindi kontra. That's just common sense. Salamat, Doctor. Dr. Sebastian, ayon kay Executive Secretary sa iba't ibang news reports, quote, sa kanila to, "We found out about it only when my staff reported that the SRA posted the order," so SO4, "SRA posted the order on its website," close quote. Pero sa kanilang statement dito naman sa Senado, sabi nila, quote, "On August 10, Wednesday, after the meeting in the State Dining Room of Malacanang, we learned that the SRA, through Yusek Leo Sebastian, passed a resolution approving Sugar Order Number 4." Close quote. Sa inyo naman pong affidavit, Doctor, sabi nyo, "I personally informed the President that the SRA Board approved the 300,000 metric tons sugar importation via referendum. To my surprise, the President disapproved of my action and the Board's approval of Sugar Order Number 4, and he informed me that we should recall the order," close quote. So, at this point, medyo nalilito ako, Dr. Sebastian. Sino ang tama? Did Malacanang really find out about the order only on the website, or did you report it personally?
Your Honor, there is a timeline there that I indicated, which is 3:51, the exact time that based on my phone log, that I called Administrator Sarapica to report the disapproval of the president and request him to recall the publication of the SO4, Your Honor.
So, pero sir, yan po yung pagbawi na. Pero yes, ang sir. Tanong ko po ay, parang yung tanong kanina, isa lang ang pwedeng tama. Nalaman lang ba talaga ng Malacanang yung or SO4 sa website? Or kayo ba yung personally nag-ulat nito kay Presidente?
I'm not aware of the timeline that was presented by the ES, Your Honor. But what I know is the timeline that I talked to the President after the meeting with the fertilizer companies, Your Honor.
So yung unang pag-alam ni Presidente dito sa Sugar Order 4 ay galing sa inyo, hindi sa website lang ng SRA. Personally, sinabi nyo kay Presidente.
Yes, Your Honor.
All right.
I informed the President that we have already approved the 300,000 metric tons sugar importation. And just like in my affidavit, I was surprised that he was not in agreement, Your Honor.
All right. And by the way po, tinanggap po ba yung resignation nyo?
As of now, Your Honor, I've been informed that I am on a preventive suspension for 90 days.
So hindi po tinanggap or hindi pa tinatanggap yung resignation nyo?
That is correct, Your Honor.
So preventive suspension, did you say, sir?
Yes, Your Honor.
Preventive suspension.
With the permission of Senator.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Can you provide this committee with a copy of your preventive suspension as required by civil service rules? It has to be in writing.
It is contained in their charge sheet, Your Honor, because they also charged me.
My question is, can you provide the committee,
yes, Your Honor,
a copy of your preventive suspension?
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Lastly, para sa ngayon sa inyo, Dr. Sebastian, so alam na po natin yung SO4, hindi na itinuloy yon. Pero yung memorandum po dated 15th July, yun po ba ni-rescind?
I don't have any information, Your Honor, if it has been rescinded.
So, posibleng hindi siya ni-rescind at posibleng valid pa rin siya. At as of today, at least as of this morning, i-cover pa rin kung sinong tao yung maaring ipalit sa inyo kung tatanggapin yung resignation nyo.
I have no knowledge about that.
Alright, salamat po, Dr. Sebastian. If I may, Mr. Chair, Mr. Sarapica, former Administrator Sarapica.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
Mr. Chair and the members of this committee, good morning.
Good morning, sir. Kayo po, ano pong nagpapaniwala sa inyo na si Presidente at si ES ay supportive sa importation?
During the presidential briefing in Malacañang on August 1, after presenting to the President and to everyone in that meeting the challenges in the sugar industry and the recommended courses of action, in my last courses of action was prepare a draft order on another import program for SRA board approval. In that instant, after everything was discussed, the President said to submit an importation plan.
So again po, kung pinapa-draft kayo ng order, kung pinapa-submit kayo ng plan tungkol sa isang programang importasyon, ibig sabihin, posibleng a-aprubahan ito. And ibig sabihin, sa meeting sa araw na yon, favorable yung pagtingin, or at least open, hindi opposed. Tama po ba yon?
You're correct, Your Honor.
And sasabihin nyo po ba yon pareho tungkol kay Presidente at kay ES, na at that point in time, pareho silang open or even pabor sa importation?
I did not hear any objection, Your Honor, at that point.
Okay. No objection din. So, just to exhaust that point, Mr. Sarapica, may dahilan naman po ba kayo para maniwala na yung 300,000 metric ton importation? So let's talk about the numbers now. Let's talk about the volume. Did you have reason to believe that the 300,000 metric ton importation was a go from Malacanang? O baka naman may indications na ayaw sa ganung amount, pero pinilit nyo pa rin.
At that point, Your Honor, there was no volume on August 1.
Okay.
There was no volume talked about, Your Honor.
Mm-hmm. So pero as this, sabi nga ni ES nung unang hearing, fiasco unfolded, at any point in time, did you have reason to believe na may go signal from Malacanang on the 300,000 metric ton volume?
As I said, Your Honor, there was no volume talked about on August 1.
What about August 4 po?
On August 4, it was reiterated again on the importation plan.
Mm-hmm.
During that time, we had already figures because we had a meeting with the stakeholders on July 29,
mm-hmm.
where we presented the facts of the situation on the tightness of the supply and the rising prices, prevailing prices in the market. So the stakeholders were requested to submit on or before August 3 their recommendations.
Mm-hmm. And did they po, at ano yung, and tama po ba Mr. Serafica? From July 29, meeting with stakeholders, hanggang submission deadline nila ng August 3, wala sa mga stakeholders ang nag-object sa importation? Tama po ba?
Wala po.
Wala. And did they have anything to say about the volume of importation?
Actually, almost all of them recommended 300,000 metric tons volume to be imported, Your Honor.
Almost
Senator
all.
Ontiveros,
yes, Mr. Chair.
Your time has lapsed. With the permission of Senator JB, are you willing to give a sufficient time to Senator Ontiveros to finish her question?
Yeah, yes, Mr. Chairman. Let us let Senator Ontiveros finish her questioning.
You may proceed.
Maraming salamat, Sen. Ejercito at Mr. Chair. I'll just wrap up on this question for now. So almost all the stakeholders, former Administrator Serafica, na meeting nyo nung July 29, I presume nag-submit sa inyo by the on or before the deadline of August 3, almost all agreed not only on the importation but on the 300,000 metric tons number, volume.
That's correct, Your Honor.
And lastly, at this point in time, bakit? Quickly, ano yung mga pinaka-importanting facts na pinag-usapan nyo with the stakeholders on July 29 about supply, about price, kung ano man? What were the most important facts na almost all the stakeholders agreed to importation and agreed to it to the volume of 300,000 metric tons? Ano yung basis nito?
When we presented the supply and demand, it was indicated in the slides, in the presentation, Your Honor, of the Regulations Department during the time. And they saw the deficit, the estimated deficit towards the end of August.
Mm-hmm.
And likewise, also, this concerns about the raw sugar, and likewise on the refined sugar.
Mm-hmm.
The SRA, Your Honor, has complete data on the facts of our demand, average demand for the last three crop years, mm-hmm. as far as raw sugar is concerned and as far as refined sugar is concerned.
All right.
So they realized upon seeing all of this that they recommended almost the same, 300,000 metric tons.
All right. So in fact, tama po ba, former Administrator Serafica, na yung lang nag-disagree sa importation of 300,000 metric tons was Delmax Trading. At yung proposal nila was a lesser, is that slightly lesser amount of 250,000 metric tons. So, na actually near unanimous, this fact would validate yung sinabi nyo na near unanimous. Kaya nahihiwagaan talaga ako, former Administrator Serafica, no? What happened on the sidelines? I'll leave it at this point, Senator Mr. Chair, Senator. Saying only na yes. Talagang nahihiwagaan ako, Mr. Chair, kasi why the subterfuge? Nalaman ba talaga sa website lang? O sinabi personally, no? Why send signals na pabor sa importasyon, hindi nag-object, tapos babawiin pala, despite the fact of this near unanimity among the stakeholders. Based dun sa sinasabi ni Mr. Serafica na facts from the SRA, yung average demand natin in the last three crop years, projection nila na estimated deficit by end of this month, bukas, Mr. Chair, both in raw and refined sugar, at siguro yung ano yung magiging shortfall. Hence, possibly, no, we will establish that in this hearing, kaya yung 300,000 metric tons. So I'll suspend for now my interpellation. Salamat, maraming Mr. Chair.